Hi folks, my name is Welly. I'm a cloud solution architect from Microsoft APAC. Today I'm going to start an initiative called Azure Reference Architecture Solution Demo. You may be aware that we have many available reference architecture and documentation in Azure. This certainly helps giving idea to some of our customers visualizing how it may look like. However, unless you really implement them, or else you may not be aware about the details, what works, what doesn't, what are the pros and cons when choosing one architecture over another. That's exactly the motivations of this initiative, implementing and refining the architecture in real action. This initiative will be implemented with three principles. Firstly, it is the feasibility, which we will ensure that the architectures are indeed feasible in the implementation. In many cases, we will refine and improve them. Secondly, it's about the reusability. We make the demo template and sample code available in GitHub so that you can easily deploy them by your own. Lastly, it's about the clarity. We will produce multiple videos starting from crash course of each services and tools used in this demo, all the way to the actual demo in actions. With that, let's start the first series about multi-region deployment and disaster recovery on Azure. This is one of the commonly asked topics, especially when customer has mission-critical applications, which can't afford much downtime. Joining me in this series, Aditya from Microsoft Indonesia. He has been awesome helping me to develop some of the demo. Throughout the demo, we will be primarily using Azure App Service, SQL Database, and Traffic Manager. Without further ado, let's get started with the background. HA, which stands for High Availability, and VR, which stands for Disaster Recovery, two of the terms which are often interchangeably used. To make sure that we have common understanding, let's first align on the definition. I'm going to use quote here from Quora by Evan Marcus stated that HA is overall science of keeping the system up and running throughout outage and failures, while VR is a subset of HA, which is also most expensive element of the HA. Now, it often implies the protections and recovery process over large scale of disaster. Coming to the Azure world, many of past service like Azure App Service and SQL Database actually provide built-in HA capability within the region where they are deployed. This in fact could be achieved with minimum or even no additional configuration. However, it may not be able to tolerate large-scale disaster, which could bring down entire region. This is where you need to plan your multi-region DR strategy carefully, including to add redundancy across another region. Unfortunately, multi-region deployment is rather a complicated architecture. You need to consider many things such as database synchronization, failing over the applications and the database. The good news is we have such reference architecture available already if you are using Azure SQL Database. Documentation can be found on the link below. This is an active-passive architecture, and here is basically how it works. There will be a web application accessing a SQL database deployed on region A, or we could call it primary region. The same deployment is deployed on region B or secondary region, or the database level, in order to ensure the data synchronizations and failover capability on the backend database. We make use of Azure SQL Failover Group, which provides us a failover database endpoint. Both applications on each region will access the database with the failover group database endpoint. On the app level, both of web app URL will be registered as endpoint to the Azure Traffic Manager. Client or browser can then access the traffic with Azure Traffic Manager URL. Since we have set the load balancing method to priority, the Traffic Manager will route all the requests to Web App A since it is on the priority one and it is also online. Only if the priority one's endpoint goes down, the traffic will be then subsequently redirected to the next priority, in this case, Web B. The application can fail over easily thanks to the Traffic Manager. However, it is not as straightforward for the database. In the upcoming video, I will explain this further in more details. This is the end of the first video. I will see you in the next one, where we will spend a few minutes walking through some of our Azure service and tools used in this demo. Thanks for watching.